Hi there, it's another beautiful week live on Bookworm. I welcome you wherever you find yourself across the globe. Welcome to Bookworm Season 3. Today is the 13th week. Don't forget, next week is the grand finale. Are you voting? Have you voted? It's time to pick up your phone now. *365*366# and then you proceed to the reader's code number to keep the votes coming in. Or you download the Speak App mobile app. You go to polls, you select Bookworm for Kids Show. You tap on your favorite reader's picture to keep the votes coming in. From week one till last week, we've seen some moments of excitement, moments of sadness. Last week, we said goodbye to 10 of our readers, both representing the upper and the lower primary category. Finally, we have our 15 finalists making it through to the grand finale, which will happen next week, the 31st of July, 2021, at the City Conference Center. I'm talking about the University of Ghana, Legon. The program is proudly supported by Planet Drinks. Planet says a world of taste. Also to Bless Biscuits, baked with love. When we are talking about snack, then I'm talking about Planet Drinks and Bless Biscuits. To adjoin some publications, to C2G Book People, making books available and affordable to wherever you find yourself here in Ghana. To Zealand Fun World, when we talk of children to have fun, then I'm talking about Zealand Fun World, located inside the Legon City Mall. To C2G Book People and the Media Serving Group of Companies. Like I said, our finalists are ready. We visited them in their schools, get to interact with their classmates, with their teachers, with the heads of the various schools, their guardians and families as well. We get to know in this episode what they've been saying about them, how the journey has been from week one till now. I'm sure you want to join the conversation. Jump onto our social media handles on Facebook. It is Bookworm Ghana. Instagram is onebook_wormgh. And then on YouTube, it is Bookworm GH. Today is a whole new filler. We get to know everything that's been happening, and I'm sure you don't want to miss. The name remains the same, FM. If you want to be part of Season 4, the moment is now. Pick up your phone, 0246-916-298, 0246-916-298. We take a break, and when we are back, we roll with you. Stay with us. This is Bookworm. Read today, lead tomorrow. You welcome back from that break. This is Bookworm Reading Competition Season 3. We are in the 13th week, like I said before I went on break. Are you voting? Who is your favorite now? I'm sure you've seen some moments of joy, moments of sadness from last week, and you don't want that to happen to your favorite reader on the final day. It's time to pick up that phone. Let's get interactive on social media. On Facebook, it is Bookworm Ghana. Instagram is onebook_wormgh, and then on YouTube, it is bookwormgh. But then if you want to vote, then it is *365*366#, and then you proceed to the reader's code number, and then you send in the number of votes that you wish to do. Or you download the Speak App mobile app, you go to polls, you select Bookworm for Kids Show, you tap on your favorite reader's picture, and then you keep the votes coming in. We have 15 finalists. We visited their schools. We get to interact with their classmates, their class teachers, proprietors and proprietors of each school, parents and guardians of this lovely finalist, and I'm sure you are eager to know what actually happened there. We are taking our first three video from the lower primary category. I'm talking about Achedi Bediakon, Gideon Ansa, and Ni Omanye. Do enjoy.
Class teacher and a class teacher for Achedi Ohinua Bediakon of Great Stars Montessori. As she has qualified to the grand finale, I urge all of you to still continue voting for her to win this competition. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Uchelo Uzuchefo, a friend of Achedi Bediakon. She is a very good friend to me. Please vote for her so she can be the winner for the competition. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Kek Abeve, a friend of Achedi Bediakon.
She is a very good friend to me. Please vote for her so she can be the winner for the competition. Bookworm, read today, read tomorrow. Thank you.
My name is Mr. Derek Ashley, the administrator of Great Stars Montessori School. On behalf of management, I wish to let all Ghanaians know and know that there is a school called Great Stars that is situated at Dansuman Exhibition. This school was created having in mind the children and having them at heart, trying to nurture them for them to have a bright future, of which we've done so in many times and we continue to do. We wish to let Ghanaians know that Trifina, Achede, they need your votes to make them win this season through competition. Please vote and vote massively for them. For the contestants, I wish them all the best and I wish that they bring the trophy to the school. Thank you.
I'm Mrs. Beatrice Indakera, the supervisor of Great Star Montessori School, which is located in Dansuman Exhibition. I am here to urge all my fellow Ghanaians that our children have really done well. They've gone so far, and so far so good. Thank you so much for your vote, for your prayers, and all the things you are doing for our children. We are here today to say thank you very much. Even though the journey has not ended, we are urging all our fellow Ghanaians to vote for Trifina and Achezi. These are wonderful children. We are with them throughout the journey, and we thank you so much. We still ask you to still continue to vote for them as they bring the trophy to Great Star Montessori. As it always says that, we always aspire higher, and this time we are going above the sky. Thank you very much.
Yeah, Bookworm has really impacted my world in many ways. In fact, she has now had the knack for new words, and she always wants to know the meaning of every word that, you know, she comes across. I remember in one of the episodes, after reading, the judges will ask them to summarize, and most of them didn't really have an idea what summary was. But after that encounter, my word is now at least into words. Now, every word she hears, she wants to know what it means and how she can put it in a sentence and stuff like that. So it's been very impactful.
Hello, Ghanaians. This is your girl, Achezi Ohenua Bediako. I have qualified to the grand finale. Thank you all for voting for me. Please, I will still need your vote to bring to my school the ultimate prize, Bookworm. Read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
To vote for Achezi Bediako, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW5.
Owusu Martin, and I'm Gideon Oti's class teacher. Gideon is a very good student. He asks questions a lot. He's very, very active. And we are all happy that he has gotten so far in this competition. We want you to vote for him so that he can bring home the trophy to the Living Spring School. Thank you.
Hello, Ghanaians. My name is Benedict. Please vote for Gideon to win the camp teaching for Living Spring School.
My name is Mabel Anan-Ansan, the mother of Gideon Oti Anan-Ansan. Bookworm has really impacted my son in so many ways. Firstly, he has been a public figure now. Whenever we go out, people see him and ask, Gideon, is it you on GNTV Junior that we see? His reading has also improved. In terms of pronunciation of new words, he has improved in it. And whenever he reads and sees new words, he just wants to find out the meaning and get improvement in whatever he does. Academically, it has improved because he wants to be the head. This is a competition, and whenever he sees others progressing, he wants to improve and be better than them. So he's improving in terms of academically and in terms of getting new words correctly spelled. That is the impact Bookworm has really done in my son's life. Thank you, Bookworm.
Hello, Ghanaians and followers of Bookworm. My name is Gideon Otian Nansa, a contestant of Bookworm Season 3 and a pupil of the Lemon Spring School. I have qualified to the grand finale of the Bookworm Season 3, but I still need your votes to win the ultimate trophy for my school, the Lemon Spring School. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
To vote for Gideon Nansa, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW13.
Hello, Ghanaians. This is Lateka of Alcide Academy, KG2R, Neo Manye's teacher. I'm so excited Neo Manye is in the Bookworm Challenge and he's doing very well. You've been supporting him all this while. Neo Manye is a calm boy, yet very, very intelligent. He loves research work and Neo Manye is always ready to answer questions. Now, I'm happy for all the support we've all given to him. He still needs more. Please let your vote come. And I'm praying that you support him so that he brings home the trophy because he's capable. Thank you very much.
Hello, my name is Declan, New Money's friend. I need you all to vote for New Money to let the ultimate trophy. Look when we today, we tomorrow.
My name is Peter Clement Krenzel, the headmaster of Alcide Academy. Alcide has been in existence for the past 44 years, a school established by Mrs. Theodora Alberta Corti. It's a school which pursues excellence, and our children love reading. It is for this reason that some of our children have gone to places to compete in reading activities. Neo Maye is one of such children, and because we start them at the foundation level, Neo Maye, talented as he is, picked up quickly and has pursued this activity and is now in competition with the Bookworm reading competition now going on in this country. We know that Neo Maye will go places as far as this competition is concerned. I have no doubt in my mind that he will surely come back with the ultimate prize to make Alcide proud and also make his parents proud. We wish him well, Ghanaians. Support Neo Maye because he is going to grow up to be an academic giant, looking at the way he has started now. I wish him all the best and all my blessings from Mrs. Corti, from the board of the school, and from management and even staff and classmates. We believe that the best will come to us. Thank you very much.
Bookworm has helped my brother in many ways. Any kind of text he sees, he wants to read it. And every new word he comes across, he wants to know the meaning of it. It's like Bookworm has given him more interest in reading, and Bookworm has boosted his confidence level and has given him and has made him more mature. So that's what Bookworm has done for my brother. Thank you.
Thank you all for your votes. I still need your votes to let the ultimate prize. Bookworm, read today, read tomorrow. Thank you.
To vote for Ni Omanye, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW8.
You saw it for yourselves, and I'm sure the kids are ready and eager to perform on the big stage next week. You've seen three. Are you voting? *365*366#, and then proceed to their code and number. It's time to have that of Abdul and Ethel Dunyon.
Hello, Ghanaians and viewers of Bookworm Season 3 competition. My name is Adovni Adote. I am the class teacher of Edgar Jabatus, and Kelly is one of my amazing and wonderful children. He's very good in reading and even assists the rest of the children in the class to read very, very well. He's now my reading officer. I ask that you help us make him win the competition. Let's all vote for him. Parents, friends, we ask that you vote for Edgar Toussaint Kelly to become the winner of the Bookworm Season 3 episode. Thank you very much.
Hello, Ghanaians. My name is Lenora Iradna Alori, a friend of Abdul Jabbar. Please vote for him to win the Bookworm for Dex Educational Institute.
Good day to all your viewers and listeners. My name is Mark Day. I'm the general manager of Dex Educational Institute, situated in Tema Community 8. Dex Educational Institute is established in 1974, and so we've been around for 45 years plus. We run from creche right through to junior high school, and we also have boarding facilities. We believe in a holistic type of education to ensure that our children are good and better to go out into the world and work. And in the past, for our performances, you can see in front of us the numerous awards that we've won over the last decade, which relate to the good work that we've been doing. The children come out here and they make a difference to the society. We are very happy that our boy Abdul is part of the Bookworm competition, and he's in class 3, and he's industrious and he's working hard. And we appeal to all of you out there to support him to ensure that he becomes a success. He's doing very well, and we are all here in Dex supporting him and wishing the program the best of luck. We urge all Ghanaians out there to please vote for Abdul to win this competition. Dex needs your votes. I mean, Dex is a good school, and Dex is, what is it? Abdul is a great boy. He's very industrious. He reads very well. And he's doing excellently. So far, he's in the semi-finals, and we're encouraging all Ghanaians out there, all the people of Tema and the surrounding areas, to please vote for Abdul. Thank you.
My name is Rafai Kasim, Abdul Jabbar Edgar Toussaint Kelly's mother, a contestant of Bookworm Season 3, Lower Primary. Bookworm has really done a good impact on my son. He's good, all right, but through Bookworm competition, he's, you know, extraordinary now. He can pronounce big words, he sees everywhere. And then he's more intelligent now. He has improved. It has done a lot of impact on him. And then I'm really proud of him, and then I'm really happy or glad he's part of this Bookworm competition. So Bookworm, we say a big thank you.
Hello, Ghanaians and followers of Bookworm. My name is Edgar Jabbar Toussaint Kelly. I've qualified to the grand finale of Bookworm. So please, vote for me to win the competition and also for Dex Educational Institute.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
To vote for Abdul Kelly, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW4.
Ghanaians. I'm the class teacher of Ethel. Ethel is a very brilliant girl, obedient, very punctual, and contributive in class. I'm pleading with you to vote for her to win the competition for Tema Christian Center School. Thank you.
Hello, Ghanaians. My name is Vanessa Opokusa Akodie. I'm a friend of Ethel. Please, keep on voting for Ethel to win the competition for Tema Christian Center School. Thank you.
My name is Patience Amika. Ethel Salikam Dunyo is my daughter. Bookworm have really helped her to know new words, know how summary is about. Bookworm have really helped her in our communities, in the school. Sometimes when we are walking around market, people will wonder if it's her they see on telly. And they do praise her to keep on reading, and the sky should be her limit. Bookworm have done a lot for her. Thank you.
Hello, Ghanaians and followers of Bookworm. My name is Ethel Salikam Dunyo. I have qualified to the grand finale of Bookworm. Please vote for me too. Win for Tema Christian Center School. Thank you.
To vote for Ethel Dunyo, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW11.
You've seen that of Ni Omanya and Ethel Dunyo. To vote, dial *365*366# and then you proceed to their code and number. We take a break live here on the show. When we are back, we head straight to speak to Mr. Nelson Kofi Poku, the CEO of Bookworm, and the director of the show, Mr. Kelvin Malos. Stick and stay, even before you head straight to the upper primary category. This is Bookworm. Welcome back from Dadsburg. This is the documentary session of Bookworm Reading Competition Season 3. We are in the 13th week. Don't forget, next week is the grand finale at the City Conference Center, University of Ghana, Legon. Are you ready? Because I am ready. Jump onto our social media handles to get all the updates prior to the grand finale. On Facebook, it is Bookworm Ghana. Instagram is onebook_wormgh. And then on YouTube, it is bookwormgh. So we get to interact with Mr. Nelson Kofi Poku and Mr. Kelvin Malo. Let's have this. Joining me now is the CEO of Bookworm, Mr. Nelson Kofi Poku. You're welcome, sir.
Thank you, FM.
How are you doing?
By God's grace, I'm blessed.
All right, we thank God for that. We are getting closer to the end of season three. You are the CEO. Let me ask you, how has it been for you?
Well, first of all, let me say big thank you to Ghanaians. Because I might say it was not easy from the beginning, getting a vision to build up something in a COVID period. You know, the risk was high. But at least so far, so good. They've really welcomed Bookworm. Though we've not covered the nation, but per what we are seeing now, there is hope. Season three has been so great. I might say there have been a lot of massive improvement comparing it to season one
and two.
Season two. In all aspects, if you check the contestants, if you check the judges, even FM himself. So for season three, it's a plus.
It's a plus. Now we are in the final stage of it, and are prepared. As you, or how prepared is Bookworm for the grand finale?
Well, Bookworm is always ready for great things because it's not from man. It's God's own vision. We are just a vessel. Mm-hmm. And for that matter, I can tell you that we are 100% ready, mm-hmm. in terms of the award, mm-hmm. in terms of the auditorium, mm-hmm. in terms of life after Bookworm. Mm-hmm. Because the season one people and season two, you could see that those who have been watching GNTV Junior, we made a promise that when we're able to qualify to the Bookworm finals, we will train you to become news anchor. We have started. Oh. So if I say life after Bookworm, that is what I'm trying to mean. So we are ever ready. All the qualified contestants in the finals here, they have their ticket that after Bookworm,
there is something for them.
There is something for them. Bookworm is one of the reality shows that we believe that it's more or less like a family. Mm-hmm. It's not that you just come and participate and go. No, we have to make sure that we will follow you, we will monitor you till you become somebody.
In future.
In future.
I'm sure there's been a lot of challenges, you know, to every successful thing that you do. Definitely you have some challenges. How has it been and how have you been able to overcome it?
Well, it has not been easy, but you know, with God, all things are possible. As I said, this program is not, I can tell you straight that it's a divine. Mm-hmm. And season one till now, if I tell you that in terms of finance, though people see a lot of companies on board, they are doing well. Mm-hmm. But I might say it's not easy, you understand? Production cost, talking about the awards, prices, talking about salary,
everything
is money, you understand? Airtime, you know, if we are to talk about the actual budget, mm-hmm. for this particular program, mm-hmm. in fact, nobody will be motivated, mm-hmm. to keep on. But we believe that no matter, as long as you live, you have to impact
into the life of people.
And therefore, that has been our motivation. Mm-hmm. So irrespective of the challenges, still it's a plus because we are born or we live to add. Mm-hmm. And therefore, that is what we are doing. So there's a lot of challenges, but
we are overcoming it.
Yes.
So when we had our 15 finalists, you visited the schools, get to interact with the guardians, parents, and all that. How has the reception been?
Well, as I said, Ghanaians are really, really embracing Bookworm. Because there was one school that we had a small challenge. Headmaster in charge has to wait for confirmation before they will allow us to do whatever.
Yeah.
And before the headmaster realized, the entire student, Bookworm is here. Then the headmaster was like, wow. Oh, boss, I beg, please, you can go ahead.
So without the confirmation coming from the top, yes, the kids said, themselves,
because sure. upon their rules and everything, mm-hmm. it's meant to guide and protect the kids. Mm-hmm. And they are, the moment they saw the T-shirt, now Bookworm, said, "My boss, go ahead and do it." You see,
so it's great.
It's evidence to tell you that we had a nice reception. Mm-hmm. We started documentary. I think they were about 36. So 36 schools, and all the schools, they gave us a nice reception, and even most of the schools are now even trying to tell us that Bookworm should come there. Like, we have to start the audition from schools. You see?
So, right. Mr. Nelson, we have to go. Time is not on our side. Okay. Final words before we wrap up the documentary session of Bookworm.
Well, I will tell Ghanaians, especially the companies, the corporate institutions out there, please, Bookworm has become a reality. And for that matter, all hands are invited. Please come and support. This is a program, but at the same time, it's something that we are trying to inculcate or maybe impart in our kids for the beginning of new generation. please, let's all come and support financial companies out there, MTNs. I mean, the big companies. Try to come on board so that we make this vision big.
All right, thank you so much, and we wish you all the best. I hope to see you next week for the grand finale.
Thank you.
So that was Mr. Nelson Kofi Poku, the brain behind Bookworm. He's actually the CEO of Bookworm Ghana. This is a documentary section of Bookworm. There's more for you.
Who wins Bookworm Season 3? Voting. Who are you cheering? Who wins Bookworm Season 3? Vote now as the contestants prepare for an outstanding, amazing, and electrifying grand finale. You also have the power to push your favorite contestant to lead. The grand finale will be happening at the City Conference Center, Legon Economics Faculty, on the 31st of July 2021. Attendance is strictly by invitation. Bookworm. Read today, lead tomorrow.
Your firm open your book. Be dry cashing out. Be cashing out to the cashing. I am with the baby, they said, they can cashing out your graph. Become
original cashing that far.
No. What will be your what? Did you need it?
Me, what, dear, soon could be. Mammy, see, ma'am. The biscuits will be. Look, this is what you try.
I get it, Mama. I can't feel the taste of cashew nut. Radio Martini and Libya.
And I hear you.
Meeting me at home.
The friend of blessed cashew nut biscuits. Gonna be a food in our cashew with you. And Muna, my very biscuit. Eddie, blessed cashew nut biscuits. Eddie, I'm Cassa.
Biscuits will be a bit. I'm going to have a cashew nut. I'm not going to have a cashew nut.
Said from the CEO of Bookworm, Mr. Nelson Kofi Poku. It's time to hear from Mr. Kelvin Malo, who is the director of the production, also the head of production. You're welcome, Mr. Malo.
Thank you, FM.
Let me also add that he also judged in about three or four episodes. So yeah,
six episodes.
Wow. How are you doing?
Ah, by God's grace, I'm good. Yourself?
I'm good too. Gradually, we are coming to the end of season three. How would you describe the journey?
It's been fantastic. We thank God for strength, first of all. And then it's been an amazing journey, especially working with kids. Mm-hmm. You see, putting them on the spot where kids will be nervous when they see lights on and they see cameras on and they see people around, how they feel nervous. So as a director, I had to take them through, groom them, how to stand before camera, how to keep your composure and be confident before people and the judges. It's been a journey of learning for myself. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So it's been great.
Now, you at a point, you had to switch from directing to judging to production. How how challenging was this?
It was tough because judging the competition, being a judge on the competition, and at the same time directing mm-hmm. the whole show, mm-hmm. it was tough because I had lots of job to do at the same time. Mm-hmm. But as a tutor of the subject, you know, media is my scope, it's my field, it's where I love to play mm-hmm. around, it's where I'm passionate mm-hmm. about. So it wasn't too much of a headache because this is what I do on the daily basis, 24/7, directing and producing shows. Mm-hmm. And judging was just a plus because mm-hmm. I teach as well. I've taught from basic level to the university now at Doc's Open University. So it's been just practicing. It was just a practical field for me.
For you. Now, we are in the 13th week. Next week is the grand finale. You visited the schools. You've seen them. How was the reception like? And moving forward, how do you see things to be?
It was great. I'm sure season four forms should be finished by now. Because every school you get to and you ask the question, how many of you want to enroll for Bookworm season four? Then you see everybody's hands up like that. The reception was great. We had schools come cheer up. We had teachers praise the program and the people behind the program. They gave accolades to you because they see you every day.
Thank you.
They extended their regards to you.
Yeah.
You could see that people really appreciate this because when you look at the content on TV now, education for the kids are less, but Bookworm has come to open up. Parents whose words were not even in the competition spoke to us and they said, my kids watch this show. And anytime you people scroll the script, they try to read and catch up. They try to say, okay, I can also do some. They go back, they take their books and also practice reading at home. So the competition as a whole has blessed most Ghanaian homes and children. And it has even encouraged parents to be watching the show as even. It's the whole show.
Because they also want to know what is happening.
So it has become a family content for each and everyone over there. And we are grateful to everybody and the production team, everybody who has put this together, including yourself.
Thank you so much. I myself have had great moments with the director. You know, sometimes I'll have an in ear and like I will say something to him and the response I get, I will sometimes it will go off speaker so that everybody can hear what.
Thank God it doesn't go off for everybody to hear.
So let me say thank you to you for the good work, and I'm sure next week we'll all meet at the City Conference Center inside the University of Ghana, Legon, for a great show.
Sure.
Thank you so much, Mr. Malo.
And then I would like to extend appreciation to the production team because my work is made perfect with them because if they are up to game, it makes the work easier for me. So to all the people at the PCR, I have Jerry, I have Sound, I have Wisdom, I have Red Card, I have Misty, I have
Red
Manasseh.
Card himself is just a red card.
And all of them. And to our producer, Jude Sam has been strong.
Jude has been great.
Throughout the journey, he's been good. He's been strong. To
like the kids'
development
father.
Team. Everybody has put out.
To Kweku as well.
Kweku is in charge of the script. And all of that. So God bless everybody. And to my fellow colleague judges and senior judges, I appreciate all of them and the push up they've given all of us to make this a success. So the grand finale, viewers out there, expect the best. We're bringing you a non-stop 3 hours reality live show. So stick and stay. You'll see FM glowing everywhere. And I will be behind the scenes and putting up everything together for you to enjoy an amazing content on the 31st of July. So expect nothing but the best.
All right, that's what he has to say. Expect nothing but the best. Are you ready? I'm also ready. Let's head straight to our upper primary category. This is Bookworm. That was a very great and insightful interaction with them. You get to know what will be happening next week. You have it on your doorstep. It's time to do justice to what you have to do. The kids will go and perform, but it's up to you, the viewer at home, to keep the votes coming in for them. It's time to head straight to our upper primary category. Let's have our first three. I'm talking about Akusuya Adade Redu, Denzel Sakode, and Eusebia Achiku.
Hi, I'm Mr. Samuel Ekodazi, Akosua Dadi's class teacher. She is in this competition and I wish her all the best. Akosua is an avid reader and of course an intelligent student. My desire for her is to win it, but she can only do that with the help of your vote. Please vote for her massively so that she can bring the prize to our school. Thank you.
Hello viewers, my name is Elina Mgumashi and Akosua Dadi is my best friend.
Akosia Dade has a really nice personality. She's good and she's a really good friend. She partakes in all activities in class. She is kind and lovely. Please vote for Akosia Dade. She deserves this. Thank you in advance for the vote.
Hello everyone. My name is Ashley Abraham Pakutu. Akosia is my close friend. She helps me learn things that I don't really understand. She is intelligent. I want you all to vote for her because she is alert in class and likes reading a lot. Thank you for the support.
I'm Mr. Edua Mankwa, head of school, Hallmark International School. Originally, this school was established in 2001, but the name changed to Hallmark International School in 2016. And ever since, the school has pursued excellence. Since the establishment of this school, or since the change of the name, everything here has changed. Our academies have moved to a new level. Our students are encouraged to be on their own. They are also encouraged to be independent thinkers. And that is the reason why one of my students in class 6, Ekosia Dade, has been voted for, because I know the potential she possesses. She's been one of our best students. She's very vocal. She exhibits leadership qualities. And she's one of our best students. I implore all our viewers to vote for Akosia Dade massively, because she has great potential. You viewers out there, vote for her. Thank you very much.
I am Emmanuel Kofi Owusu. I am Akosia Oredu's trainer. In fact, I was first of all teaching Akosia, even though she was good. But when she began Bookworm, there has been a massive improvement in her reading. Besides, it has also built her confidence level. He has developed the ability to read. In anything that she sees, she reads it. The confidence has been built, and even in school, there has been significant improvement. Bookworm has impacted on her so great that, in fact, there is no way we will ever regret making her part of the competition. In fact, Bookworm has done a great job. It has impacted greatly on her life. So thank you, Bookworm, and all your organizers.
Hello, Ghanaians. This is your girl, Akosia Badadiredu. Thanks for voting for me, for making me qualify to the finals. Please, I still need your votes to win this competition. Please, keep on voting. Thank you.
To vote for Akosua Yeboa, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW35.
My name is Moses Aounu, a teacher of Jack and Jill International School. I am also the school's secretary and happens to be Denzel Sarkodie Ado's class teacher. Honestly, if there's anything I can say about Denzel, then it should be a word that I can use which might be more than bookworm. Because Denzel is academically exceptional, is very bright. He believes in research. Every word he always approaches me, "Sir, I have researched this word, and this is the meaning, and this is the part of speech it is," and so on and so forth. Very good. Even though we have exceptionally equally good children in the class, but he stands always tall among them. So when the first day I have heard that Denzel Sarkodie joins the competition to participate in the bookworm reading, I only said that, that's just a walkway, because Denzel is automatically going to win. I encourage a few friends, colleagues, and parents that Denzel is at the right path, because I know how he reads and the way he has masterpiece over all words, whether new or not new. So my wish for him is that the day of final, he should be pronounced the winner, declared the winner. But above all, everything has to do with finance. So I pray and also ask all parents, guardians, friends, and even the school's authority to help him with their votes. I can say that when you dial *365*366#, you press his unique code to be BW21. Then try him, vote for him. It's a good cause. If you vote for Denzel, your vote will not be in vain. Vote for him. He is proven beyond a reasonable doubt that he become one of the greatest personalities in this country and even across all the tempestuous seas. So I pray to see him at the final emerging as a winner. Thank you very much, Bookworm. I need to thank you sincerely. You do all this to bring the natural things that are in these children to bear. I am so grateful. But extend it beyond Accra. Go to other villages and bring those who are equally good to the same scene or a picture. Thank you. Long live Bookworm and long live Ghana.
My name is Julie Tawusu. I am in class 6C and I attend Jack and Jill School. I would like for you all to vote for Denzel so he could bring the ultimate award to Jack and Jill School and raise Jack and Jill School's name higher. Remember, Bookworm, read today, read tomorrow.
My name is Jahora Draman Yusuf. I am a friend of Denzel. I have known Denzel when we became friends in class 4. He is talented in English. He knows how to pronounce words as they are. He's fluent, and I know he's going to win this competition and bring back the championship to Jack and Jill School and to raise the name of Jack and Jill School high and fly as high to the top of the sky and even above of the sky. And I pray we all vote for him by dialing *365*366# and the unique code is BW21. May God bless you. Thank you.
My name is Kojo Kwache, and I'm the managing director of Jack and Jill School at Roman Ridge. Jack and Jill School was founded in 1975 by Mrs. Agnes Kwache, who was a visionary lady, and it started with 6 students. Since then, it's grown to about 900 students. And we're a school that believes in a holistic form of education. So the body, the mind, and the soul. So we don't concentrate just on academics, but the moral training, the building of character is just as important as academics. We also have been around for quite some time. So we have students in every walk of life, from medicine to academia, you name it. There are Jack and Jill students there. Now, Denzel has been with us for quite some time, and he's gained the respect of his classmates. He's a very disciplined individual. He reads a lot. He loves to take part in all school activities. And we know that he has a very bright future, not just on the Bookworm competition, but even beyond that. It is our prayer that he emerges the overall winner of the competition. And we hope that all of you give him your support. Thank you. Have a nice day.
Hello, Ghanaians. This is your boy, Denzel Sakodiado. Please, I have qualified to the grand finale of Bookworm. I want to bring the ultimate award to my school, Jack and Jill. But please, remember, you can vote for me by dialing *365*366# and the unique code is BW21. Thank you. Bookworm, read today, read tomorrow.
To vote for Denzel Sakodiado, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW21.
name is Isaka Kotogiba. I'm the uncle of Isebia Teteki Acheku. Isebia Ateki is very respectful, very learned. She doesn't joke with her book at all. You always see her reading her books. My wish for her and where she has gotten to, I want the general public to vote massively for her to win the ultimate prize, because she's doing well and we can all attest to it. The ultimate prize must come home, and we expect every Ghanaian to assist to vote massively for Isebia Acheku. Thank you.
Isebia is a very good girl at home and even at school. She likes reading, and her performances, she does better, and I mean best all the time. When she's at home, she would like to help even at the kitchen, and whatever you're doing, she's always interested and she wants to know. Before Bookworm, Isebia reads already, but with Bookworm, she wants to read all the time. And at times she will even connect her tablets to the big screen, the TV, in the living room, and she'll be reading, and she'll ask us to, you know, monitor her speed. Because of the way she likes reading these days, even the siblings at home are also reading like that, and they want to be part of Bookworm reading. So I will urge all Ghanaians, please vote for Isebia the day Teteki to win the overall award and bring it to Bema Camp Services Primary School. Thank you so much for your vote.
My name is Acheku Simon. My daughter is Isebia the day Teteki Acheku. The issue with Isebia is complacency, so I was glad when this opportunity was opened up to her, to bring her out of her, draw her out of her comfort zone and come and compete with other pupils from other schools. This experience has given her a boost in her reading and building her vocabulary. And so all I have to say is that we thank Bookworm and its organizers for the opportunity that this has presented to her. Thank you.
Hello, Ghanaians and amazing viewers of Bookworm Across the Borders. My name is Isebia Dede Teteki Acheku, a contestant of Bookworm Season 3 and a pupil of Services Primary and GHS Bema Cup. Please, I have qualified to the finals of this competition, but I still need your vote to win this competition. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
To vote for Isebia Acheku, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW46.
*365*366#, and then you proceed to their code and number, or you download the Speak Up mobile app. You go to pause, you select Bookworm for Kids Show, you tap on their picture to keep the votes coming in for them. Our next set is Tryfina Tete, Asida Atia, and Asari Mufida.
Ghanaians. My name is Alfred Nawin, the class teacher of Tryfina 30. She is qualified to the grand finale. She still needs your vote to bring the winning to Great Stars Montessori School. I'm counting on you with all her respectfulness and high quality. I know that you're going to vote for her, and she is going to bring the cup to Great Stars Montessori School. Thank you, and I'm counting on you that you're going to do as usual. Thank you very much.
Hello, my name is Newton Ajime, a friend of Tryfina Tete. She's a very good friend to me. Please vote for her so she can be the winner for the competition. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow.
Hello, my name is Georgina Jekum, a friend of Tryfina Tete. She is a very good friend to me. please vote for her so she can be the winner for the competition.
It's Mawili Kofi Sanji, Assistant Administrator for Grey Stars Montessori. We started this journey with many children, but we've gotten so far to the quarterfinal, and we had Trifina and Acheze. We thank you so much, Ghanaians, for keeping our children in this contest so far, and then we are grateful for your votes. Please, we want your vote more so that they can go high and bring us a trophy to this school. Grey Star Montessori and these children are very thankful to you people. So we beg you that keep them in the competition for us so that, as we say, aspiring higher is our motto. Thank you.
Hello, fellow Ghanaians. My name is Samuel Kofinti, and a brother of Trifina Fepe, the contestants of Bookworm Season 3. At first, she was a shy type, but when Bookworm started, she has been able to gain her confidence level and also help her in her punctuations and her reading. So we thank all the organizers of Bookworm and also urge Ghanaians to keep on voting for her to bring the ultimate prize to the house. Thank you.
Ora Jones is the name. Grey Stars always aspire higher. So far, so good. I'm very, very, very impressed with the children. They are doing very well. I like their competition, the way they read. In fact, it's marvelous. Keep testing, keep voting. We need to push higher. Thank you very much.
Atomi Adiel Ama. Domoshikiha Trifina Tete. Trifina Tete. Eni. Natural Eroja Odate Man Bruce. Ofaine E Fatalogi. Omwene Trifina Tete Dine Die. Minko Fai. Wapi Lede Aneche Finals. Wombi. Koni Mine Wani Vote Mi. Awa Hao. Men ni no ni vote han le ke yo wa kon bi ni ma ne wala ke wale ni na shika ne vote ni ale ko bu ko ne ona ke ba an ko ne san e wa abfa we a ke e ne improve te ni e ka se mo ni ke ne ke ka se mo she ke mo ko wo le ka ni ke e ka se mo ko wo le ka ni de ye ni wo ne me ke che ni wo pa fa ke na le ni 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 vote ni han le one be you are the name you are the king wala koni vote ne afahale koni enye next week e to you are as no final say e ban life when you vote ne ali koni vote ne e agi when afa ni ken clean be ye enye ne wu enye ti no ni bi oni ni buku en bi en meni ke buku en mu ba mu amo won damage shi ake am ken de ke educated nutu money ba program ne ba I am not be a shoe demon by Molashin and Baba. Oh, money look book well, nay, he won't pass. Can be a shake. I can ask a woman next year. A can be a woman. Can be a bacon, a cup of poetry. A cup of poetry, too. She moan, and a bit of putting. Nebula, Bangman of Kajan was saying. Well, she won't know where he won't pass. I will make an amazing name. Never to another trifling at 30. Many, many are booty fair outside, fainting for another trifling at 30. Ebi ami ni won pa fa ni na omo mo ni vote ni hawo ni de no ni graduate ni ni fi oni ni won da ni shin won da ni shin yo wa den ta jo ni ne wo ni shika ni tumo ni tumo fe ya ni shere ma ba mi ni ni he credit ni vote ni hawo e Jesus Christ ba ni amen.
Hello Ghanaians, this is your girl Trifina Tete. I have qualified to the grand finale. I still need your votes to progress to the next stage. I need to bring the ultimate prize to my school, Grey Stars Montessori School. Bookworm, me today, me tomorrow. Thank you.
To vote for Trifina Tete, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW25.
Hello, lovely people of Bookworm Season 3. My name is Asari, a sister of Asida Etia. When we got the information that he has been enrolled into the Bookworm Season 3 competition, I was very glad because I knew he's a very intelligent guy, smart, and likes to explore a lot. So when he was auditioned and was selected as one of the participants to compete in this Bookworm Reading Competition Season 3, we were very happy. So we supported and helped him throughout the season. It's been good throughout the season. And here we are at the finals. We hope and pray that he takes the ultimate prize home. It's our prayer and our plead to all parents out there that they should help and support us to at least find out to help us push through and bring the ultimate prize on Bookworm. Read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
If I want young men, I was all in fair near Radon, I can see. Hey, okay, when you mean, I said that I share. Ne fair near Drumona, no more Drumona. It was Henny Walker when you mean, I said that I share. Nyen fair near Radon, why join your fair, I can see your fair. Ne hand when you mean, I said that. And you won't find your fire crew, I can see. Bejan only yet to take her as a da voting. Kehan a kind Bejan and ne fear ne ha one a kind no. Connie Walker and Nagby. What's the market when you mean no Benny Ages in there? None more drum on a cabar Nagby. Connie no fear no affy for Kaha Nanumbo. Near Radon, I can see about Fenny Howe. Near voter and near how when you mean no, I said that. Mboba Johnny. Me and of you, but the cuckoo no me. Me and of you, I said that. Eya do be mi ado vivile un be finance olaya mi do vivile un be mi a vote na mi an ovi asida ela bena eja gbanyue nto ta mode kukuna mi vote na mi an ovi asida ma una yira mi kata.
My name is Rachel Owusu Etuya. Jaden Asida Owusu Etuya is my son. Bookworm from season 1 and season 2. Asede Etuya told me about Bookworm. And I told him he's a shy person, so he can't make it. Then a colleague of mine told me to help my boy. So I said, let me give him a try. I tried Asida. Knowing him as a shy person, I didn't know Asida can improve to this stage. In fact, Bookworm has really helped Asida in reading. His academic performance too has changed. Asida likes reading, but now, he's been challenged to read a lot of storybooks, and wherever he sees storybooks or anything written somewhere, he wants to have a try of it. He wants to pronounce words. In fact, he has really improved. And I want to say a big thank you to Bookworm for the confidence level that my boy has gotten to. Now, wherever he goes to, he wants to challenge everyone. He wants to read. He wants to tell people about Bookworm. His colleagues and friends in school and even at church always comes around him. The reason is that Bookworm has improved my son academically, and then he has also improved Asida, being not shy anymore, but he can stand confidently and talk about Bookworm. I am so grateful to the organizers of Bookworm, and I'm grateful to Asida's fan. I'm grateful to everyone who has made an impact in Asida's life, especially the trainer who is training Asida. Thank you, Bookworm, and I say kudos for what you have done. Lovely viewers, I say continue voting for Asida to take the ultimate crown. Thank you very much.
Hello, Ghanaians and amazing viewers of Bookworm Across the Borders. My name is Jaden Asida Ogusetia, a contestant of Bookworm Season 3 and a pupil of University Basic School. Please, I've qualified to the grand finale of this competition, but I still need your vote to win this competition. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
To vote for Asida Etuya, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW42.
My name is Daniel Agbesi. I am the head teacher of Kindercare Montessori School, and I've been in this school for the past 3 years now. So we are doing everything within our power to ensure that the learners, as much as they can, to be able to become responsible adults in the near future, in order for them to be able to become a better adults, to ensure that everything will be done in a diligent manner. So it's my hope that Mufida Asari will be the ultimate winner of this Bookworm program. Yeah, so please, we urge all Ghanaians to vote for Mufida Asari so that she will be declared the winner of this Bookworm program. Thank you very much.
Hello, Ghanaians. My name is Akose Awusu-Anyako. Please vote for my friend Mufida so that she can bring the trophy to Kindercare Montessori School. Thank you for your help. Please vote for her very well. Thank you.
My name is Madam Mansura Suberu, popularly known as Mother Kindercare. I am Mufida Oredua Asari's teacher. We are here today to tell you about Oredua and Kindercare Montessori. Oredua is a good girl. Academically, she is good. She's always, she does everything to excel in her academic work. She is a leader. She is forceful. She doesn't joke with her academic work. She does everything you ask her to do. She is a good girl. She's a child, a parent, every parent will want to have. And so I am not surprised that Fida got to that far. We have not had the opportunity to do a lot of training with her, but with the academic work that we do in class, I was not surprised she got there. If we had chosen any other child in this class, I'm sure the child would have done the same. But Mufida has done extremely well. We have monitored her from the first stage all the way to the finals, and we were like, without, you know, much happening behind the scenes, like rehearsals, because academic work is taking everything. And so she's done well. She's done well. I give her thumbs up. She's done very well. And we are happy. So fellow Ghanaians, please, please vote for Mufida Asari for her to be the winner of Bookworm Season 3. We urge you to vote for Mufida. Thank you so much for all those who have voted for her, those who have prayed with her and prayed for her. We really, really appreciate this. Thank you very much.
My name is Ibrahim Asari, the father of Mufida Oredua Asari. I must say, Mufida has been a fan of Bookworm. She started following the program from the first season up to now. So during the second season, she mentioned to me that she wants to take part in the program. I picked the forms and we went through the audition successfully. Bookworm has improved her tremendously. Her reading skills has improved and she has been able to increase her research abilities, and she can now recite a lot of things, and she's able to pronounce huge words that previously she was not able to do. So now Mufida has progressed to the final stage of the competition. I want to encourage all family and friends and loved ones of Mufida to vote for her and keep her in the competition so that she wins the final, the ultimate prize. And again, I will also advise all parents to encourage their children to keep on reading, and they should also involve themselves in the competition, because Bookworm builds their confidence, and that's what I would like to say. So kindly vote for Mufida for her to win the competition. Thank you.
Hello, Ghanaians and amazing viewers of Bookworm Across the Borders. My name is Mufida Oredua Asari, a contestant of Bookworm Season 3 and a pupil of Kindercare Montessori School. Please, I've qualified to the grand finale of the competition. I still need your vote to bring the trophy to Kindercare Montessori School. Bookworm, read today, read tomorrow. Thank you.
To vote for Mufida Asari, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW41.
You've had six, remaining with four. But before I mention their names, this is the invitation card for Bookworm Season 3. So if you get this card, it means you can join us at the City Conference Center inside the University of Ghana, Legon, on the 31st of July 2021. But if you don't have, then you can sit behind your TV set or follow us on our social media handles. On Facebook, it's Bookworm Ghana. Instagram is onebook_wormgh. And we also be live on our YouTube channel. It is Bookworm GH. So our final four, we have Christabel Yaboa, we have Elizabeth Amponsan, we have Enna Mofori, and Aaron Nyama. Do enjoy.
Fellow Ghanaians, I'm Sena Tanodenchi, the class teacher of Christabel Ansuman Yeboa. Christabel is a very good student. She likes asking thought-provoking questions. She's the best there is. She always likes to read and take her assignments seriously. And I urge you all to vote for her so that she wins the ultimate prize for Silicon Valley International School. Thank you very much.
Hello, Ghanaians. My name is Akosua Bempoma Ejapon, a good friend and a classmate of Christabel Ansoma Yeboah. Please vote for her to win the ultimate prize to our school, Silicon Valley International. Thank you.
I am Natalie Kasifo, principal of Silicon Valley International School, an institution that has been in existence since 2002. We are committed to the academic and holistic training of children in the best way possible. It is for this reason that we have a wide range of extracurricular activities, well-trained teachers, and a conducive environment for this kind of training. It is no wonder that one of our own, Christabel Yeboah, is doing so well on the national front. We are very grateful for all of you that have been supporting her this far. We say, Christabel, congratulations on coming this far and making this milestone. We wish you the very best. Thank you.
My name is Abuajira Monica, a sister to Christabel and Suma Yeboah. Christabel and Suma Yeboah already likes reading, but through Bookworm has really impacted on her. And through Bookworm, she can now pronounce words. It has improved his reading skills and also his vocabulary. Thank you.
My name is Patrice Yeboah, that's father of Christabel and Suma Yeboah. And then it's been a while since we started this program. That's a reading program for kids. I think somewhere in April, early April, we started this program. And every week, being a parent, you will have to, you know, bring your kids to, you know, the program so that they partake. Actually, Christabel has been the type who loves reading right from age 2 to 3. And then he will tell you that when you're coming back from work, I need storybooks. Okay? And if you make a mistake and then go and get her a storybook, which has some few content, you will just use some few hours to finish all of it. And it's like, hey, Charlie, my money is gone. In the right aspect, you understand. So we got to a point in time, I said, look, I have to get a storybook with more content. Okay, then go through and see if the words are okay for her to, you know, read. And then she's been like this since those 80s, and then it's been good. At times she'll be reading and I was like, hey, this is my girl or something else. Okay, so we took part in this program. She's actually wanted to partake in the season 2, but then looking at time and then work, we couldn't come. Season 3 is in Daddy. We have a season 3 and I want to be part of it. I said, okay, this time around, you know, and let it come. In all, I would say thank you to the organizers. They very, very much done well. And then you can see when it started, the program started right from the scratch. It wasn't easy for some of the kids. But then as time goes on, you can see there's been vast improvement. The confidence level has gone up, and then they can, you know, cope up with whatever is going on. So it's a plus for the organizers, and then we ensure that, you know, you get more sponsors on board, so that at least the judges' score being 80, and then maybe the public being 20. This will encourage other parents to, you know, bring their kids. And then, you know, everything will be fine. Bookworm, read today, lead to tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Hello, Ghanaians and amazing viewers of Bookworm across the borders. My name is Christabel Ansoma Yeboah, a contestant of Bookworm Season 3 and a pupil of Silicon Valley International School. Thank you all for voting for me. I have qualified to the grand finale of the competition, so keep voting for me to win the ultimate prize to my school. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
To vote for Christabel Yeboah, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW24.
Hello, Ghanaians. My name is Madame Gloria Kokoyi from OPA MA Basic 1. Elizabeth Kokoyi is my student. Very intelligent, smart, and driven. I believe that is the reason why she has excelled in the competition so far. Please do vote for her. We are counting on your support. Vote for her so she can bring the ultimate prize to our prestigious school. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Rahel Banks. I'm a friend of Elizabeth Koko and Ponsa. I want you to vote for her so that she'll win the ultimate prize of Bookworm.
I'm Pemdako Asafo, headmistress of OPA ME Basic School 1. OPA is located in Gawest municipality, 2 kilometers away from Accra Main Road, off the Insawam Road. OPA Basic 1 was established in the year 1990 with a primary section. So later on in the year 2000, we established the JHS section. So currently we have from KG up to JHS 3. OPA Basic 1 is a school noted for its academic excellence. Because academically the school is doing well when it comes to BECE consistently, the pass rate has been around 80 to 85%, and then most of our pupils pass and pass well. They obtain the grade, and as a result of that they get admission into category A schools, and afterwards they are doing well. In terms of academics, we have well-trained teachers who are dedicated to their work, who are punctual to school and regular as well. And when they come to school, they discharge their duties as well. And as a result of that, we've been able to nurture Elizabeth Koko Amponsa to this far. You attest to the fact that the qualities that Lizzie has exhibited throughout this contest shows that we are not joking, we are doing well, and we are expecting that support will be given and then she would get to where she wants to get. OPA Basic 1 school is a force to reckon with. We are disciplined, we train the children holistically, so that any environment that they find themselves, they'll be able to cope. So we are appealing to the public that they should support the girl with the votes that she needs. And we are hopeful that come what may, 30th July, OPA Basic 1 and Elizabeth Koko Amponsa will be crowned the best in the Bookworm competition. So we are hopeful that we will smile, because there is a word that says that he who laughs last, laughs best. Thank you.
Fellow Ghanaians, my name is Jennifer Ofosia and I'm a friend to Koko. So I beg of you to vote for her so that she can win the ultimate prize and bring the glory to OPA MA Basic 1. Thank you.
My name is Anthony Tete Amponsa. My daughter is Elizabeth Koko Amponsa. Ever since we started this program, she has improved greatly when it comes to reading. Initially, she told me she wanted to be part of a Bookworm season. I didn't trust her. But when we came for the audition up to this point, I can see she was a shy type. But with the program, she has changed totally. And I can see that now she's outspoken, she's outgoing, and the reading, she has intensified her reading because she also wants to do best in the competition. So what I would say is that I give thanks to the organizers of such a wonderful program, and I say congratulations to all of you. Thank you.
Hello, Ghanaians and amazing viewers of Bookworm Across the Borders. My name is Elizabeth Koko Amponsa, and I have qualified to the grand finale of the competition. Please, I need your vote to win this competition. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
To vote for Elizabeth Amponsa, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW44.
morning, fellow Ghanaians. My name is Peter Duncan, and I'm teacher to my dear Enam Ofori. Enam is another jovial and serious student. And this competition has exposed her to a lot of things. And I believe where she has gotten to, she's definitely going to bring the ultimate prize to Santa Barbara. And all that I want to say is that please, where she has gotten to, all she needs is your vote. So vote for Enam to bring the ultimate prize to Santa Barbara. Thank you very much.
Hello, Ghanaians. My name is Solomon Kwame Amiyao, and Amofori is a friend of mine. Please vote for her to bring the cup back home to Santa Barbara School. Thank you.
Yes, this is Santa Barbara School, and I'm Linda, Mrs. Linda Darko, the head of primary and JHS departments. Santa Barbara was established in the year 2005. And currently, we have six of our JHS students who have written BCE, and they came out successfully. And most of them had their first choice schools. Currently, we are preparing the seventh batch. To do with Enam, she's been with us for 4 years. She's currently in class four. And she's a studious child, obedient and hardworking. She informed us about her program she's contesting in, which is a bookworm. And we are all ready to give her our support in diverse ways. In brief, I'll say I wish her well. And it's my prayer that she comes out successfully at the end of everything, so that she'll be able to get to the next level, which is the final stage, to win the final award, to make the name of Santa Barbara School go far. So on that note, I'll urge all students of Santa Barbara School to vote for Enam, as well as the general public, our dear mummies and daddies, older brothers and sisters at home, aunties and uncles, to vote for her. A vote is just 50 pesos, and you can vote as many times as you want to make her come out successfully. Thank you.
Well, my name is Sylvia Nayua Mofori. Enna Mofori is my daughter. I would say Bookworm has really impacted on my daughter positively. Actually, I didn't know about Bookworm, but she was the one who told me about it, that she's interested. So she forced me to watch the advert. So I asked her if she's really interested. She said, yes, okay. And I said, if that will be the case, I'll help you get the forms. So we got the forms. We were called for the auditioning. In fact, when I saw the people, I was so scared for my daughter. But luckily enough, she was picked. And throughout the competition, she has been doing so well. Bookworm has really impacted on her reading skills. Her confidence level has really improved, and now she can easily pronounce big words. And I want to say I'm very grateful to Bookworm for all that they have been doing from day one in my daughter's life. Now she has become a star in her school. All her friends, wherever she is, they want to come close to her because Bookworm has made her so popular. Thank you, Bookworm. Thank you to our fans out there who has been voting, who have been supportive from day one. God bless you all. Thank you.
Hello, Ghanaians. My name is Renee Enna Mofori. I'm a contestant of Bookworm Season 3. Please, I've qualified to the grand finale. I need more vote to win. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow. Thank you.
Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow!
To vote for Enna Mofori, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW33.
Aaron Niama is one of our best students here. He's a very hard working and is always ready to cooperate with other students, especially when teachers are not in. Aaron set in to teach the junior ones. And also here at Mission International, every Wednesday we have Bible studies. So at times when the preacher is not in, Aaron is the one who steps in to teach the children Bible. He knows Bible very well, and he's also time conscious. Please, I want you all to vote for Aaron Nyama to bring this victory to Mission International School. Thank you, and God bless you all.
Fellow Ghanaians, I am Jason Sowa, a friend of Aaron Nyama. I hope you vote for Aaron in Mission International School. Thank you.
Hello, fellow Ghanaians. My name is Karen Esikwamia, a sister to Aaron Nyama. Please, I want you to vote for him to win the competition. Thank you.
Hello, Ghanaians. My name is Gabriel Bedu, boy school prefect of Mission International School, and in the same class with Aaron Nyama. Please, I would like you to vote for him to win the competition for Mission International School. Thank you.
My name is William Yanuyama. I'm the father of Aaron Nyama. Aaron expressed interest in taking part in the Bookworm program when about 4 months ago he told me about it. And looking at Aaron, and most of the time, the way he likes watching the program, I decided to give it a trial. And I must say that Bookworm has really helped him, especially when it comes to the pronunciation of the word, and has also improved his vocabulary, as well as the speed at which he also reads. And it has also made Aaron very popular in his school, and people always want to get close to Aaron. And I must say, Bookworm is doing a very good job, and we are very, very grateful and hope that more people will come in and then know more about the program, and it will go to a much higher height. Thank you very much. We are grateful, Bookworm.
Okay, thank you. Next person.
Hello, Ghanaians and amazing viewers of Bookworm. My name is Aaron, and I have qualified to the grand finale of Bookworm. I need your votes to win the competition and bring victory to my school. Thank you.
To vote for Aaron Nyama, dial *365*366#. Proceed to BW52.
So you've heard from their parents, their guardians, their teachers, classmates, and heads of the various schools. To vote for them, download the Speak Up mobile app. You go to polls, you select Bookworm for Kids Show, you tap on their picture to keep their votes coming in for them. Or you dial *365*366# all networks here in Ghana. Follow their code, and then you keep the votes coming in. So this represents the upper primary category. I have Aaron Nyama in no particular order. This doesn't mean when I mention your name first, it means you are first for the grand finale. I have Aaron Nyama, I have Eusebia Acheku, Elizabeth Amponsan, I have Trifina Tete, I have Akosua Dadejiredu, I have Denzel Sakodie, Enam Ofori, Aseda Etuya, Asari Mofida, and Christabel Jabua. These are our final 10 for the upper primary category. And then when you go straight to the lower primary, we have Abdul Jabbar, we have Achedi Bediakon, we have Ni Omanye, Ethel Dunyo, and Gideon Ansam. From week one, they've been with us all the way from 1st of May, right from the audition 17th of April to the beginning of the maiden, the third edition, the 1st of May, they've worked. They've improved, they've learned a lot, and on that final day, they want to be crowned as champions. Support them with your vote as they come to make you proud as their favorite. To all 55 candidates who joined us for this term, 40 living, we say we love you so much, we appreciate you, and we hope that as you are watching, you join us on the 31st of July 2021. Many thanks to all our supporters for making the program a reality. To Planet Drinks, we cannot go without you. To Blessed Biscuits, to Adrensa Publications, to C2G Book People, to Zealand Fan World, CJ Multimedia, and the Media Serving Group of Companies. To the entire production team, you have been massive, you have been marvelous. You've worked day in and out to make sure the program becomes a success. To our director, Mr. Kelvin Marlow, and to our CEO, Mr. Nelson Kofi Poku. My name is FM. To the parents out there, thank you so much for supporting the kids. To our judges who worked with us from day one till now, I'm talking about Mr. Ivan Sadisi, Mr. Kelvin Marlow, Madam Lydia, Madam Nancy, and Mr. Courage Chega You have all been massive. To one of our judges who helped us in course of this, to Mr. Kweku Enchi, thank you so much. To everyone who joined us through the entire season, my name is FN. Jump onto our social media handles. Let the votes come in. Let's get interactive. On Facebook, it is Bookworm Ghana. Instagram is @Book_WormGH. And then on YouTube, it is Bookworm GH. This has been Bookworm Documentary. See you next week for the grand finale. Bye-bye.
Who wins Bookworm Season 3? Now. Have you voted? Are you voting? Who are you cheering? Who wins Bookworm Season 3? Vote now as the contestants prepare for an outstanding, amazing, and electrifying grand finale. You also have the power to push your favorite contestant to lead. The grand finale will be happening at the City Conference Center, Legon Economics Faculty, on the 31st of July 2021. Attendance is strictly by invitation. Bookworm, read today, lead tomorrow.
FM open your book. Do you have cash you not? The cash you not, the cash you not. I am with them every day, like a cashew nut of your work, become
original cashew nut farm.
No. What will you want it?
It will be good.
Me, what, dear, so good. Mommy, see, man. Me, biscuits, so good. Me, first, I will try.
I get it, Mama. I can't feel the taste of cashew nut. Where do you want tea and Libya?
And I hear you.
Me, tea, make it warm.
A friend of blessed cashew nut biscuits. Ghana kwa food in our cashew would you have. And Muna, my berry biscuit. Eddie blessed cashew nut biscuits. Edda Kasa.
This is what we are saying. I want to have a cashew nut. And I am. And I give it. And I bless me. Who's going to suit you? Who's
going to bless me? FDA, Aji, a daddy in Kratu Yatu.
In the Upper East region of Ghana. Relax as I present the history and rich cultures of my people. Bosa descend from Mamprusi Prince from Narigugu Adatugu and a blacksmith from Kurugu called Kasena. Bosa lies in the Upper East part of Ghana in a 2,000 square kilometer area. We are mostly farmers in grains and nuts, poultry, weavers, and blacksmithing. Living in mud huts, we speak a language called Buli. Our staple food include suma beans, muma rice, and tuonzafi with wakta jenta soup. On important occasions, we dress in a beautiful fugu by the men and gangsta fugu by the women with beautiful jewelries. We celebrate the Fiok Festival. Fiok means abundance of food. It is celebrated in December in memory of victory over the slave raiders in the 18th century. Then during the festival, war dancers wear buffalo horns in a form of hat, looking and walking like wild buffaloes, signifying how they scared the slave raiders out from their land with bows and arrows with fierce dance. 100 years ago, Bakona was one of the most important Bosa villages. It was probably the first name of a Bosa settlement that appeared on a map. After the trade, road passing Sandima, Wiga, Jimbenda, and Fumbisi replaced the old routes. Bochansa declined more and more in importance and inhabitants. Thank you.
Are we ready now?
Yes.
All right, let's go.
I would want to be a farmer. Ladies and gentlemen, call me Domina the farmer. Why? Because we eat to live. Hence, food is very important for the survival of the human race, including all of us seated here today. I know many would always prefer to become doctors, lawyers, engineers, etc. In as much as they are all good professions, I see agriculture farming to be the source and sustainer of all professions in the world. There is a quote that is very accurate when describing a farmer. Farmers farm for the love of farming. They love to watch and nurture the growth of plants. They love in the presence of animals. They love to work outdoors. They love the weather, maybe even when it is. A farmer's main goal is to produce a good crop and or healthy animals in order to make a living to feed their population. Farmers are responsible for all crops and livestock that are needed for us to survive. Without food, the world would slowly die. Farmers work hard every day to keep plenty of crops and animals products in the market to keep that from happening. I yearn to feed Mother Ghana and beyond. For it is said, when the last tree dies, the last man also dies. Thank you.
All right, thank you so much, Domina. Madam Nancy.
Domina the farmer.
Yes, welcome to my farm.
Wow, I'm already in your farm. Let me go straight to your questions.
Yes, madam.
Okay, there is a quote that is very accurate when describing a farmer. Can you give me that quote?
Yes. Okay. Farmers farm for the love of farming.
Very good. Clap for yourself. And your second question. From the passage that you just read, what is the responsibility of a farmer?
The responsibilities are, farmers are responsible for all crops and livestock that are needed for us to survive.
That is good. Clap for yourself.
Thank you so much, Brian.
With some local stories. Let's support the Ghanaian media. Minister for Information Designate Kojo Opon Nkrumah has called for increased support for the media in the country. According to him, the Ghanaian media plays a critical role in our democratic dispensation, hence must be assisted to go about their activities in a free and independent manner. Taking his stand before the Appointments Committee of Parliament on Thursday, Mr. Nkrumah noted that the media plays a critical role in information dissemination in the country. As a result, the needed support to make the media come under intense scrutiny, particularly after the 2020 general election, for compromising on professionalism, objectivity, and accuracy. While admitting the shortfalls in the work of the media, he acknowledged the critical role that the Ghanaian media was planned to sustain the country's democracy since it returned to democratic rule some 25 years ago. This is all by way of some local news on Bookworm. Stay tuned, we have more for you. My name is Mai Ajumendo.
Bookworm Reading Competition Season 2, news anchors. Dad Leader, your comments, please.
I must say I enjoyed your reading.
Thank you.
And you were not engaging your audience, which you need, because you are what? Speaking not to yourself. So you have to engage your audience by looking at them. For Brian, I like the eye contact and the confidence with which you are engaging your audience.
Thank you.
You've done so well. That's good.
Thank you. You can leave us now.
Akan is one of the six major ethnic groups in Ghana, and it is the largest ethnic group in Ghana. Akans are a unique group of people who are dotted in the most parts of the country. Kou is one of the subgroup of the Akan ethnic group. Like most of the Akans, my people also celebrate Akwesidai annually. The festival also provides the community the opportunity to commune and communicate with their ancestors. Take stock of our activities of people. Plan ahead of the coming year and thank God for his protection and provision over the year. The Kweu Easter, which has now been accepted as part of Kweu's culture and national celebration. Ketesi Ministry of Tourism, Culture and Creative Arts has a flurry of socio-culture activities in addition to how the indigenous Kweu use the Easter to meet their families, resolve family problems, engage in festivities and observe quiet time. The grandeur of the activities that mark the Easter includes paragliding, hiking, carnivals, and stream jams. Thursdays, the Kweu people now see the Easter as an annual homecoming, whilst the holiday revels look at it as an occasion for celebrations. They are engaged in all manner of trade. The prominent ones are the production of tiger nuts, shallot and poultry wares, and pesi, fufu, rare soup, and bats. Apai are the delicious dishes they enjoy most. Thank you.
Thank you.
Legal professionals who can pursue a variety of career paths. Becoming a judge involves extensive education and experience to develop the necessary skills, knowledge, and abilities involved with the job. One also needs to learn hard in school, develop the habit of reading, earn a bachelor's degree, take the law school admission test, complete a law course, pass the bar exams. A judge oversees a trial or hearing, serving as an impartial referee and making decisions on which arguments, questions, and evidence are admissible. A judge may also determine the extent of punishment level during trials. Judges don't do all of their works in the courtroom. They perform certain duties outside the courtroom. In chambers as well. They research laws and regulations, issue opinions and case decisions, supervise the work of law circles and other cult staff meet with attorneys to discuss cases and encourage settlements and establish court rules and procedures. Some judges also perform marriage ceremonies and issue marriage license. Skills needed in becoming a judge: develop the decision-making skill, develop the listening skill, enhance reading comprehension ability, polish one's writing skill. Some of the notable judges in Ghana are Her Ladyship Georgina Wood, former Chief Judge of Ghana, current newly appointed Council of State member Her Ladyship Sophia Akufum, former Chief Judge, Her Right Honorable Bamford Addo, former Speaker of Parliament. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Judge Kwekwenchi.
Lordina, that was impressive. Great. Take these questions. Mention one skill that a judge needs.
To develop the decision-making skill.
I like that. Two, aside working in court, they also perform outside the court. Can you mention one thing that they do outside the court?
Marriage ceremonies.
Okay, that's great. You've done well.
Thank you so much. You can go backstage.
Good day, viewers. This is the new segment on Bookworm. My name is Lordina Jenfi. Now the headline. Inflating support for Dr. Owusu Efriye Akoto, Minister Designate for Food and Agriculture. Farmers and input dealers in the Upper West Region have declared their inflating support for Dr. Owusu Efriye Akoto, Minister Designate for Food and Agriculture, ahead of his vetting on Friday. The farmers say Dr. Akoto spearheaded various interventions which have improved the living standards of farmers in the region. Mr. Alaska B. Kanto, leader of the farmers who was speaking on behalf of the farmers, explained that the government's agricultural initiatives such as the planting for food and jobs, the fertilizer subsidy program, the planting for food and export program, which were spearheaded by the minister designate, are among the many policies that have changed. A recap of the headline: inflation support for Dr. Owusu Efriye Akoto, Minister Designate for Food and Agriculture. My name is Lordina Jenfi. Over to you, Airam Ajua and Ku.
Jazanchi.
The three of you have so much energy. I'm a bit confused as to how to score. You've done very well. Your confidence is on point. Just a little with eye contact. That is Abra and Ku. But the three of you are excellent, and I hope you stay together, okay? You've done very well. Congratulations.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes.
All right, start reading for us.
My root. My name is Aria Madra Anku. I am a hybrid of an Igbo father and a Kobo mother. I trace my paternal ancestral lineage to Chukpe Tota, located in the North Dying District of the Volta region. While Chukpe Tota can trace its roots further back than the late 80s, the community really started developing during that time. Following the colonization of German Togoland, the people of Chukpe were formerly known as the Bataklewo, meaning the people of Batakle. Batakle was led by a high priest called Batakle, who said the deity called Bata, and the people were known as Bataklewo or Klebiwo. have a very rich culture evident in our food, language, dressing, music and dance, festivals and hospitality. The chief staples of my people are cassava, yam, cocoa yam and corn. And their favorite delicacies include the very popular akpele with abobitari, fufu with palm nut soup, kokonte with groundnut soup, banku with oko soup, dabi among others. The Igbos of the Anglo state celebrate the Hokpetotozan annually in November to commemorate their exodus from Nochie in Togo to Ghana. A key feature of the festival is the traditional Huzago dance, which mimics the tactical backward movement of our ancestors when they were leaving Nochie, so that anyone who looks at the footsteps will think the people were actually moving towards into Nochie at Benami.
Pename.
My dream of becoming a medical doctor. My aim of becoming a medical doctor is largely driven by my dream to be part of a profession that focuses on helping others who are suffering regardless of their circumstances. A dream to be part of a profession that also focuses on helping others live much a healthier life, which translates to a happier life. For this, I want to be a medical doctor. Medical doctors perform health assessments, run diagnostic tests, prescribe medication, create treatment plans, and provide health and wellness advice to patients. Medical doctors can specialize in specific areas of health, such as dermatology, neurology, gastroenterology, or gynecology. They might also perform surgery. For one to be a doctor, one should offer a science course in the secondary educational level and should have passed these relevant subjects, including elective biology, chemistry, and physics. The doctor has many roles to perform. Few of such roles include assessing health of patients and prescribing medications, promoting health education on communicable diseases and non-communicable diseases, as well as diseases of public health importance, example, COVID-19 disease. There are different fields of the medical profession. These include cardiologists, is a doctor who treats problems of the heart and blood vessels. Psychiatrist is a doctor who diagnoses, treats, and prevents mental, emotional, and behavioral disorders with the use of medication, neuromodulation, and psychotherapy. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ayura Majua Anku. Madam Nancy, questions.
Dr. Ayuram, wow. Let me go straight to your questions. Are you ready?
Yes.
Okay. From the passage that you just read, name one specific area a medical doctor can specialize. From what you just read. Those words that you were rattling. Should I go to the second question?
Yeah, time is up. Next question.
Has she been bailed out?
Yeah, next question.
Okay. What science subjects should one do at the secondary school to be able to qualify to do medicine?
You should learn elective biology, chemistry, and physics.
Very good. Clap for yourself. Well, you see, I love the reading that you did. But you know, you are reading with understanding so that you'll be able to answer your question. So when it gets to this part, don't just come and read, but you read with understanding. So then when they ask you a question, you'll be able to answer. Aside that you did so well, and you look good in your outfit as a doctor, I wish you all the best, okay?
Good. Show some love for Ayram Ajua Anku. Thank you so much, you can go.
panel decision that the Electoral Commission cannot be compelled to call a chairperson, G. Mensah, to testify in the election petition. The earlier panel comprising Chief Justice Kwesi Anenyeboa, Justices Apau, Mafosau, Nene Ambegacha, Prof. Koti, Maria Mawusu, and Getu Tokonu ruled that the EC board's finding a witness statement does not mean she has to testify. The court also said that the positions and affidavits with regard to the interrogatories do not mean the witness can be compelled. The Chief Justice, who read the decision, explained that no provision in the Constitution or statutes has been pointed out to show that the EC chairperson can be subjected to different rules contrary to established rules of procedure and settled practice. My name is Aria Madra Anku, and this is Bookworm News. Please sit, relax, and stay produced as we cross over for some international news with Jehu Pell.
Judge Anchi.
The three of you have so much energy. I'm a bit confused as to how to score. You've done very well. Your confidence is on point. Just a little with eye contact. That is Abra Anku. But the three of you are excellent, and I hope you stay together, okay? You've done very well. Congratulations.
Of Tong. Tong is an Ewe speaking community in southern water of Ghana. The word is compound Ewe word. Tong is river and Ngu means near, hence Tong meaning near river. Tong is made up of 13 traditional areas. They include Mafi, Bakpa, Mofo, Bato, Dofo, etc. The largest of these traditional areas is Mafi, where I come from. Our main occupation is farming and fishing. The food we eat is okra soup, fetridashi, and awakpla, kokontekpla, and palm nut soup, and several others. The men put on rich kente weaved by our neighbors from Patwe in the Volta region on their shoulders and beads on their wrists and necks, while the women dress beautifully like their men and me. The Ewe have an intricate collection of dances, which vary between geographical regions and other factors. Some of these dances are Agbaja Ajida, used to entertain people during social and recreational activities. Let me ask you, have you spoken to stone before? The answer is no, but come to Mafi. We can boast of talking stone and to Gbeju, a bomb thrown by the whites for destruction but couldn't harm the people. This attracts people from the four walls of the country. We live in beautiful houses built with mud and thatch. A typical example is Soga Kope Beach Resort. Thank you. Akpenami.
A heart of applause will do. A heart of applause will do. Yes. That is a product from Bookworm Reading Competition Season 2.
Major is not required. All medical school applicants need to complete undergraduate coursework in biology, physics, chemistry, and mathematics. Students can gain healthcare experience while in school by volunteering in hospitals, clinics, or other healthcare environments. Doctors also need the following skills: problem solving, leadership, empathy, and communication, as well as proficiency with specialized tools and technology. Becoming a medical doctor requires obtaining a bachelor's degree in human biology and a master's degree in both surgery and medicine and serving an internship. Medical doctors also need state licensure or certification to practice. Medical doctors can specialize broadly in surgical, medical disciplines, or public health. Some basic equipment used by medical doctors include stethoscope. It is used to hear sound from movement within the body like heartbeats, intestinal movement, breath sounds, etc. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Jehupel, a medical doctor in the future. Two questions from you, Judge Lydia.
Okay, Jehu, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
Kindly answer these questions for me.
Thank you.
According to the passage, how can students gain healthcare experience while in school?
By volunteering in hospitals, clinics, or other environments.
Lovely. That's good. Your second question. According to the passage, aside education, what do medical doctors also need in order to practice or operate?
Licensure and or certification to practice.
Beautiful. Put your hands together for yourself.
News. COVID-19 cases on the rise in South Africa. South Africa, where a more contagious COVID-19 variant has been identified, accounts for nearly half of continent's death. Africa has surpassed 100,000 confirmed deaths from COVID-19. The continent, praised for its early response to the pandemic, now struggles with a dangerous resurgence and the medical oxygen often runs desperately short. Africa has reached 100,000 confirmed deaths shortly after making a year since the first coronavirus infection was confirmed on the continent in Egypt on February 14, 2020. Africa, the hardest hit country on the continent, saw over 125,000 excess deaths from natural causes between 3rd May and 23rd January. This has been the new segment with the lower primary category on Bookworm. The news was brought to you by Blokem Industries, CrossGet Events, Media 7, SpeakUp Mobile App, GNTV Junior. For more news updates, log on to www.bookwemga.net. Follow us on all social media handles at Bookworm. My name is Jane Hupel. Thank you for watching.
Judge and Chi.
The three of you have so much energy. I'm a bit confused as to how to score. You've done very well. Your confidence is on point. Just a little with eye contact. That is Abra and Ku. But the three of you are excellent, and I hope you stay together, okay? You've done very well. Congratulations.
Gandambi, the ethnic group. I chow mini ayikwe aite. I am a proud Ghan. I come from Gamashi. We speak the Ghan language and are patrilineal in Ghana. The Gandambi ethnic group can be found mainly in the Greater Accra region, which is the capital of Ghana, the seat of government of Ghana, the Jubilee House.
traditions state that the Khan came from the region of Lake Chad, a region that's in the 16th century. We were organized into six independent towns: Accra, Gamashi, Otu, La, Teshi, Nungwa, and Tema. In my tribe, every name is prefixed with Ni or Na in reverence to our grandparents who first bore the name we are given today. I will encourage my other contestants from other ethnic groups to visit the Kolegono Beach Resort for relaxation. Tourist sites like the Kwame Nkrumah Mausoleum, forts and castles like the James Fort at Jamestown, the Arts and Culture Center, and Kotoko International Airport, not to mention a few. But please, try to update the safety protocol because COVID-19 is still with us. You know what? In case you're unwell and you happen to be on my land, don't worry. We have the biggest teaching hospital. That is called the Teaching Hospital, with quite a specialist you can think of to help you recover. Thank you. Oyewalade. Aspiring to be a civil engineer, I am Engineer UPBIT. Scientists, investigator, which already is. Engineers, creator, which has never been. It is science to describe electromagnetic radiation, but it is engineering to build a radio or TV, according to Albert Einstein. I have always had a desire of creating new things. I love to see nice buildings, roads, etc. This is a beautiful apartment project I have in my hand that I would like to build for the CEO and judges of Bookworm Avenue Consult. This desire has made me go to light designing, creating new things, and also working in a team. That is what civil engineering is all about. Civil engineering, the professional engineering discipline that deals with the design, construction, and maintenance of the physical and naturally built environment, including public works such as roads, bridges, dams, structural components, and buildings and railways. In short, civil engineers shape the world we live in. Civil engineers possess an academic degree in civil engineering, the degree which allows students to further specialize in their particular interests. To be a civil engineer, technician, you need excellent maths, science, and IT skills the ability to explain designs, ideas, and plans clearly, the ability to analyze large amounts of data and assess solutions, confident decision-making ability, excellent verbal communication skills, project managing skills, the ability to work between budgets and budgets to deadlines, and good team working skills. Ladies and gentlemen gathered here, please contact me. We are ready to build your dream house. Thank you.
Thank you. Make sure you take the contact number. Mr. Evans.
Mr. Engineer Aite. Engineer Papa. Anyway, you've done so well. Let's answer the following questions, please. What subject do you need skills, what subjects do you need skills in as a civil engineer according to the passage?
Math, science, and IT skills.
Correct. Your next question. According to the passage, if scientists investigate that which already is, what do engineers do?
When the scientists investigate it, engineers build it.
Okay, I'll give it to you. I do.
Thank you so much, Uriel. You can go backstage.
Good day and welcome to the new segment on Bookworm. My name is Prince Zero IT. Now, let's take a look at some local stories. The Information Minister nominee, Kojo Opa Nkrumah, have transferred the circumstances that led to the collapse of a microfinance institution he had majority shares in. The microfinance company, Over Microfinance Limited, was among 247 insolvent microfinance companies whose licenses were revoked
during the banking cleanup in President Takufo-Addo's first term. Mr. Opo Nkrumah was the managing director of First Brownstone Capital, which was the largest shareholder of Oval Microfinance Limited. Moving on, residents living in and around Kumewu in the central Kumewu district of the Ashanti region must travel all the way to Ifiduase and Asante Ajim Agogo to access emergency health care. This is as a result of the entire roof of the Kumewu Polyclinic, which has been ripped off following the heavy rainfall on Monday dawn. Stay tuned for more news updates. My name is Prince Ro IT.
Bookworm Reading Competition Season 2, News Anchors. Judge Leader, your comments, please.
I must say I enjoyed your reading.
Thank you.
And you were not engaging your audience, which you need because you are what? Speaking not to yourself. So you have to engage your audience by looking at them. For Brian, I like the eye contact and the confidence with which you are engaging your audience.
Thank you.
You've done so well. That's good.
Thank you. You can leave us now.